Hi everyone. So in the last video, we were talking about the functions we are defining in the interface. So actually I was doing a mistake because we do a lot of JavaScript. So I was trying to put that kind of syntax here. So in the functions, you need to put the function name, like say hello is I'm putting the function, and here I'm passing param is of type string. So here the return type of that function is whatever it is returning. So if it is returning string, then that will be the type. Now you can create a class which will implement this interface X. Okay. Now you need to define all these methods, public say hi. And you need to follow the same syntax. It is accepting some argument. Okay, can be X of null. Okay, and it should return nothing. You will see this, because if I'm returning null, it means I'm trying to return something. I'm not returning anything now. Now again, the another method which we have is public say hello. This is another method which is returning a string, and it is accepting argument of type string. Now it is fine, right? It's working fine. Same thing is it's not necessary that you should use these functions like this. You can also define the function definition somewhere else. So I created a type, my function type, which is having this function, and this function is returning a number, right? So you can also define something like this. Interface is this. On the on change equals to this function name on string, and it is returning number as an argument. Okay, it's a single number argument, right? So the definition of this and this is totally different. Okay, this is returning a string, so this is also, you can replace it with this. So here say hello, let's try to do this. So say hello and it is number, call and expected, because here what we are doing is mapping, right? So here say hello, and I'm passing the param as a string argument, and it is returning string. Similarly, here it is a type replacement. If I try to manage that, then most probably I will get an error, because here I'm trying to put a key value. On change is of type my function type, right? So this is a different from whatever we have done here, little different. So I created a custom type. The type is nothing but the type is just a function. It is just arrow function. It is, I will say it is a function which is returning a number. If I say it is returning number, then we can write it something like this, right? But it will just ask, then type is expected. So we are putting an arrow function here. Now it is fine, right? So this type, same type I am assigning to the onChange. It is a little confusing for me also. Like here say hello function, this is the function definition. Function statement only, not without definition, it is returning string, right? Same thing, we can override that by declaring a types here. Okay, so if you wanted to skip this, skip it. Just define your functions like this, say hello or say greetings. Okay, define your type. T is okay. See, let me try generic here. That's working well, right? Now here I also need to override this. Say greetings. Let me just check. Say greetings is missing. Now I have implemented it, and X can be of type number, let's say, or can be of null. So whatever I'm expecting, I'm returning that. That's cool, right? So these things, when you are mixing a lot of things, here you can just say X can be of type null, can be of type undefined, or can be of type string. Right here you are just saying it's union. Here also you can say it can be a void, it can be null, or it can be undefined. Right, so here these are the best examples to mix the things. It can return the string, it can return the void, or it can return null also, right?